Hey everyone, there's a bit of a debate about whether you should put fans below your graphics card, because some people say the PSU is often below there, so it's actually going to, you know, heat up your GPU. But I've done loads of tests, and in this video I'm going to prove whether you've got an ATX case or a mini ITX case, it is often better to have fans below or in front of your GPU. So what I actually did is I run loads of different tests, including Furmark, which stresses the GPU but it raises temperatures throughout the system, so I kept track of loads of different system temps. I also run Steel Nomad, which is a gaming benchmark, but that's good for actually seeing the effect on the CPU and also the GPU. And then I run Prime95, which stresses the CPU, but again that'll drive up temperatures for other things as well, whether you've got fans or not. So then I kept track of all the temperatures, including the GPU temps, and I tested this for both my ATX case and my mini ITX case. For my ATX case, you can see the actual specs on screen now. So it's an ATX mid-tower case, the Ryzen 7600 X870 motherboard, 32 gigs of RAM, an RX 9070 XT AMD graphics card, and then I use 30mm thick fans from Corsair, the RX 120 Max RGBs, which are part of their Link system, and I put those below the graphics card. And naturally I tested with the fans running and also not running, so I run the stress test we looked at earlier, Furmark, Steel Nomad and Prime95, with them running, and then you can see them completely stopped, and I rerun all of the tests. And here are the actual test results. So in Furmark you can actually see that with the fans, with the green bar, there is a difference. I mean, not so much with the CPU and the NVMe drive, they're sort of within the margin of error. But the chipset is surprisingly cooler with having those bottom intake fans on the PSU Shroud, and then the GPU seems to benefit from that too. Then if we go on over to Prime95, you can see, yet again, there's a difference, not so much with the NVMe again, but everything else is improved when running Prime95 in my ATX case when you actually have those two fans below the graphics card. So yes, it is obviously right above the PSU, and that will get hot, but actually it's still helping to cool things overall. Then I run Steel Nomad, and actually the CPU results aren't that different, but everything else is. And I rerun all these tests multiple times, and I did wait in between tests to make sure the temperatures went back to normal, and I made sure that the ambient temperatures were actually, you know, the same. So it's not like I just run things once and cherry picked the best results. You know, I did run things multiple times and kept things as consistent as I can, and you can see the results here. So I think actually it is quite significant. So that's for my ATX case. Then for my mini ITX system, I've got a Corsair 2000D, an 8-core Ryzen CPU, the 7700, again 32 gigs of RAM, mini ITX motherboard, the X870 Pro Ice, and an RTX 5080 FE, and then slimline fans. And here are the results. Unfortunately, I didn't capture the hotspot temps in this particular case, but actually you can see that the CPU and the GPU temps are again better when you actually run fans in front of the graphics card. So these are little 15mm slimline fans, they're not the 30mm, you know, chonky boy ones I had to my ATX ones, but it still did make a difference. Both the CPU and the GPU are benefiting from actually having those fans in front of my RTX 5080 Founders Edition. So that is Furmark. Then with Prime95 you can see the results here, and you know, the CPU is within the margin of error, but the GPU definitely benefited from actually having those fans in front of it. So that's great, and if you've got any questions, please let me know down in the comments. But other than that, if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.